Hello everyone, welcome you all for the today's session. In today's session, we are going to discuss two things. One is classification and second one is operations of data structure. First, we'll start with the classification now. When it comes to a classification, it is going to be broadly categorized into two types. First one is primitive data structure and second one is non-primitive data structure. We'll see one by one what is primitive and what is non-primitive data structure and how it is going to be classified further. So when it comes to a primitive data structure, it is directly operate upon the machine instructions and it is going to be predefined in the language. So what it going to be hold is, it is going to hold only a single value in one specific location. So this is what primitive data structure. When it comes to a non-primitive data structure, it is not defined in the language and it is going to be created by the programmer. So normally the non-primitive is derived from the primitive data structure. Now we'll see what are the classifications of primitive data structures are available. So it is going to be classified into a four types. We'll see one by one. First one is an integer. Normally we'll know about what is integer. So it is normally used to represent the numeric data. For the case we'll be using integer. Second thing is, we are going to see about the character type. So character is going to store a single word character. This character can be either a uppercase or lowercase. This is what character. And third one is a float, primitive data structure. Float is normally used to represent the fractional number or number with the decimal figures. This is what float, primitive data structure. And final one is Boolean. Boolean can take up to only two values and these values either can be a true or false. So when we'll be using this Boolean primitive data structure is, it is normally used for conditional testing. So these are the four categories of primitive data structure. Now we'll see about the non-primitive data structure categories. When it comes to a non-primitive data structure, first, they are going to split this into two categories. What are those two categories is, first one is a linear and second one is a non-linear. So first we'll discuss about what is linear and how it is going to be differ from non-linear primitive, non-primitive data structure. So when it comes to a linear, it is storing the data inside the memory in a sequence manner. Sequence manner means, it is going to store the element one after another. This is what linear. So where each and every element is going to have a successor and the predecessor except the first element and the last element in the list. This is what linear. When it comes to a non-linear, it is not going to store, means here each and every element is connected with two or more items in a non-linear arrangement. So this is what linear and non-linear. So now we'll see categories of linear as well as the categories of non-linear. First one is array. So what is array here is, array is nothing but it is going to store the collections of similar type of data items and each and every data items is called an element of the array. So when it comes to an array, here each and every element is going to be have a same variable name, but the each and every one element is going to carry a different index number. For example, I'm going to represent the age. In that case, how I can represent the age using array concept is, if I'm giving as a array of some 15, in the case age is going to be a same for all the element, the index is going to be vary. Like I'm going to represent as a age of 0, age of 1, age of 2, and age of 3, till I'll be representing that as a age of 15. This is what array. Second thing is, we are going to see about the stack. When it comes to a stack data structure, here we are going to represent in by means of operations. So what it means is, here insertion and deletion operation is going to be performed at a single in. We can say that is a LIFO concept, last in, first out. Okay. Next one is a linked list concept. When it comes to a linked list, normally it is used to maintain the list in the memory. It can be seen as a collections of nodes, and it is going to be stored in a non-contiguous memory locations. Again, further, this linked list will have a various categories. We'll be seeing that in the upcoming session. Next, final classifier of linear is queue. When it comes to a queue, again, here we are going to represent that by means of operation only. Here, the queue operation like insertion and deletion is going to be takes place at different end, which means insertion will be performed at one end and deletion is going to be performed at next end or different end. We'll be calling this as a first in, first out concept or FIFO. So these are the four categories of linear data structure. Now we'll move on to the non-linear data structure. So non-linear data structure is going to be classified into two levels only. One is a graph, another one is a tree. So when it comes to a graph, we are going to store the element in a pictorial representation, and this element is going to be connected by a link, and this link will be called as a edges. When it comes to a tree concept, here we are going to have a multi-level data structure with hierarchical relationship among the element, and this element we are going to represent it as a node in the tree concept. So we'll have a doubt. Moreover, graph and trees are going to be the same. So what is the major difference between these two is, graph, when it comes to a graph, it is going to be have a cycle. But when it comes to a tree concept, here we are not going to have any cycle over here. So cycle means, so if we are having a graph where we are starting, there itself we are going to end the node. So that will called as a cycle. So these are the classifications of non-primitive data structure. So now we'll go on to the second topic, which is nothing but operations of data structure. When it comes to operations of data structure, we are going to have some six operations here, basic operations. So first we'll start with the traversing operation. When it comes to a traversing operation, what it will do is, it is going to visit each and every element in the data structure. So what is happening here, if we are visiting each and every element, is it is going to help to perform some operations like searching and sorting. So this is the traversing. When it comes to insertion, insertion is nothing but we are going to add an element into the data structure. Either it could be an array, or it could be an linked list, or it could be a graph, whatever it might be. Simply, we are going to add an element to the existing data structure. So next thing is, we are going to see about the deletion. So deletion is nothing but removing an element. So whatever it might be, either it is a tree or linked list, if you are trying to remove an element from the data structure, you can move up with the deletion operations. So this insertion and deletion can be named as a different in each and every data structure concepts. So in stack concept, they'll be called as a push and pop. So similarly, when it comes to a queue, they'll be called as a end queue and the queue operation. So whatever the operation is going to be the same, but the name is different over there for each and every data structure. And fourth one is a searching operation. So normally the searching is used for finding an element in the data structure. So if I want to delete the element or I want to insert an element in a specific location, in that case I need to find the place. For that case we'll go for a searching operation. And the final one is a sorting and merging. When it comes to a sorting technique, we are going to arrange the element in a specific order. So what is the advantage of arranging the element is we can perform the operation with minimum time, right? So normally we used to expect that only whenever we are doing some operation, we need to complete that in a quicker manner and it need to consume only minimum time. So the for doing that purpose, we need to perform the sorting concept. And next one is a merging. So a merging is nothing but combining the two different set of elements, which means two elements or two groups will be there. In these two groups, we are going to have a similar type of elements. So that is what merging. So I can give an example, like if you are having a two list, A and B is there, and the size of this list is going to be M and N. So if we are combining this, it is going to produce a third list, which is nothing but M plus N. So this is what merging concept. So these are the basic operations we are going to have under the data structure. Now we'll see some of the questions that frequently asked in the GATE exams or NET exams or some other competitive exams here is, so they'll be having some basic questions like classifications of data structures. So they will be giving all the some classification, like they'll be giving array and they'll be giving the stack, queue and linked list, and they'll be asking that whether all this belongs to a linear data structure or non-linear data structures. This type of questions is possible. And second thing is they'll be asking the operations also. What are the basic operations that are possible in the data structure concepts? So this is a basic topic. So you are not going to get some complicated over here. Only basic questions you are going to get from that. So when we are going into the each and every topic in a deeper manner, there we'll be discussing about the some more GATE questions and the NET questions. So thank you once again for watching this video.